Robin's playing vicious cleanup detail.
Hello, everybody. How we doing? And welcome to the VGR cast, episode 18. Wow, 18 weeks already.
Guys, we're
single. Hey, thanks for the sub, Nat. Nat says it's my 10-month subversary. Can we talk?
Have Ryan talk about the Blackhawks draft pick and his in-depth scouting report that he has clearly put together on the young German.
Okay.
Hold on. Joining me this week are my lovely friends, Christine, Monica, Ryan, and Mike.
I'm more than a friend.
Oh shit, it's gone off the rails already.
I'm a fuck buddy.
Ryan, go!
Ryan, yeah.
I don't know about any of the skaters this year in the draft. So there you go.
Listen, is it Ryan's sports corner yet? I didn't think so.
No, that's
we had that last week.
No, that's an every week thing now.
Oh wait, I want to see how I look with the other.
Yeah, I'm gonna make an animated intro and everything. Like I'm gonna make this whole thing. It's gonna go Ryan's sports corner and some baseballs are gonna fly across screen.
In 2 years, we'll finally see it.
No. Okay, I'm gonna make it. I had this idea the other day. I used to be a wizard in...
You're a wizard, baby!
I used to be a wizard at PowerPoint animations.
Ooh, with all the, like, the little anime... Me too! I was good at that! I made a whole fucking scene!
An absurd amount of animations.
Yeah, oh yeah, it's gonna, like, baseballs fly everywhere, hockey pucks fly everywhere, footballs fly everywhere.
I made
Ryan's Sports Corner!
No
straight paths either, just, like, all over the place.
It'll be gaudy as fuck in Comic Sans.
Oh, God!
Ryan's Sports Corner will be written in Comic Sans.
Fuck this shit, I'm out.
Oh, so just like
hold on.
Do you need
another sub? Patrick subbed. I'm here for Ryan's Hawks and Bears hot takes and to hear about whatever the hell is happening with Achievement Hunter. Don't worry, Patrick, we'll get to that.
Achievement Hunter, yeah.
Because that's a...
It's a hot and fresh mood there.
I mean, we could have started with that.
No. Hang on, let me...
That's why the crop on.
We're already talking about it. So, we'll get into it.
Let the non-Achievement Hunter fan know what the fuck's going on.
Yes!
You'll find out.
Yes, you'll find out right now. So, thanks for the 13 bits, Chris Adili, who's totally not sitting right next to me.
Those were the rest of my bits, by the way. So I gave them to you. That means I gotta spend money.
Jude was getting delayed no matter what. You knew that.
Okay, so.
Anyways.
First things first.
So, most of us are pretty big Rooster Teeth fans and therefore Achievement Hunter fans. There was some news this week.
Sad news.
Just to set up the timeline a couple days ago. And it involves a character or a person in Ryan. Not our Ryan. Don't worry. These allegations. These allegations are not against
these
the
allegations
man in the lower corner over there.
Are against a man in Texas.
Yes. Not this guy down here. He's fine.
Texas.
Hey.
Two days ago, I guess something popped up online of a young woman who claimed that Ryan had sex with her while he was married, so he cheated on his wife, and she was 17 at the time, so illegal.
Although she told him that she was 18.
Getting to that. So today, Ryan came out and said that he was leaving Achievement Hunter, and he was pretty much done. Don't bother me. Don't bother my family. Like, I'm quitting to fix my family kind of thing. This pretty much confirmed that whatever she said was true. She also made another video today that I actually watched. And in it, she goes on to explain more about what happened. And essentially, they met at conventions a couple times and they hooked up, as the kids say.
She was one of those,
groupies.
Yeah, groupie.
Yeah, basically, pretty much. She was a groupie that became a mod of his stream. And she said, so she was 17 at the time, but she told him she was 18. She never says that in the video, but she says he thought I was 18, which pretty much says I told him I was 18.
Yeah.
So I don't think that...
I should, brief aside, if this happened in Texas, where Rooster Teeth is located, the age of consent in Texas is 17.
Oh, yeah. Perfect.
So it's, nothing.
But where was PAX? Because she's
that's the whole thing.
I think they said PAX East.
PAX East. Hang on.
Which would be like New York.
We have the big. Okay.
Oh, age of consent is 16 in Washington.
All right, there. Fine. Completely legal. Fine.
Pacific Northwest is weird.
But still, so Ryan Haywood is essentially...
age of consent in Illinois is 16.
17.
It's 17
in Illinois.
Mm.
Maybe
anyways, I'm thinking of Wisconsin.
So, Ryan Haywood, like, one of the founding six members of Achievement Hunter.
Not founding, but...
One of the core six.
Okay, he's one of the core six, but he's not a founding member.
One of the OG six.
They hired him after they hired Ray.
I know, but... Ryan was before Ray.
Anyway.
No, Ryan was after Ray.
Ryan was after Ray.
Anyway, so he's one of the... So when I think of Achievement Hunter, I think of the six people.
Mm-hmm.
And so a second of the big six is now gone, which is really sad because he was like really big and he was still because like when Ray left, it was very expected. Like, you know, you could see the writing on the wall. He was kind of being a lot more quiet in videos and he was going more streaming focused. But like, this is like way out of left field.
Yeah.
This is like he's been a lot of stuff. He has his own show right now.
Yeah.
Oh no more technical difficulties.
I'm actually like three episodes behind the technical difficulties.
That's
like,
something I watch every week actually.
I liked when he modded the Nerf gun. That was funny.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
That would have been perfect for HBZ, goddamn. Awesome.
Big sad about
two.
Dude,
my top two favorite Achievement Hunters have left now.
Well, Jeff didn't really left.
No, what it was Ray and then it was Ryan.
I never really got, like, Ray had funny moments, but, like, as a consistent character, I didn't like him. I mean, I didn't not like him, but, like...
But if Kevin had to rank him, Ray would probably be six.
No, back when Ray was around, Jack was six.
Fuck you, yeah. Jack is the best!
No, fuck Jack.
You! Now Jack is the best, but back in the day when Ray was around,
Jack was a dick. Here's a Jeff quote. Fuck you!
The issue that I saw people bring Jeffrey. Up was whether he received/saved nude photos. I believe
we don't
that,
know. I mean, well, we honestly don't know anything.
I mean, but the whole thing
is all conjecture.
It's touchy because if she was 17 and said she was 18. But like
again, both of the states in question, the age of consent is appropriate 16. Here. So that doesn't even matter. 17.
That's true. Okay, fair. But I remember, a couple days ago,
I think nude photos are different than age of consent.
I don't know. I don't understand that. But so, like...
Well, I mean...
I would imagine so.
Pedophilia.
A couple days ago, I did see someone comment, and I think it was either Jeremy or Fiona's Twitter post or something, that, like, they were like, oh, you might want to, like, let Ryan know that some nudes of him are circulating online. And, like, and I kind of saw that, and I scrolled past it thinking, just a stupid bot or something, someone trying to stir up drama.
Well...
And this happened, I'm like, oh...
She's still trying to stir up drama.
Yeah.
And I guess yesterday, Achievement Hunter canceled one of their streams, so it's disabled. No, it was yesterday.
Oh.
Yeah, and they disabled replies on the tweet where they announced they were canceling it. So it's like, oh, oops.
Sarah says, "I'm surprised nothing with Meg is coming out because he was accused of doing stuff with her like years ago." Yeah, I mean, like the whole Ryan Meg thing, they've always been really good friends.
They
joked about it.
No, they're just really good friends.
That was a joke to piss off Gavin.
Yeah, because Gavin bagged a really hot chick. And what's funny is she chased after him.
Yeah, he bagged a literal model.
Yeah. Beautiful. God, I love her. Sorry, babe.
Speaking of her, she
hey, Ryan, you want to take my wife somewhere else to eat?
Meg Turney actually released a coffee table book, I guess is what I would call it.
But it's like
of full nude photos.
Which,
it's $120, I think.
Oh, okay.
But it's like, oh, no, thank you.
I mean, yes, please. But how about half the cost of $120? I'd pay $60 for a book. I'd pay $60 for a fucking game every other month. And they don't even have boobs.
Splitting the cost of a nude photo book. Now that's relationship goals.
Well, and Gavin was...
Well, babe, if you really want to.
We need to save up for something else, so...
Yeah, my graphics card.
So this is the last stream because Kevin's going to die.
Yep, I'm dead. I'm a dead man. Bye, guys. Nice knowing you.
This is Christine's stream now.
It's VGR Chris.
You like Gloomhaven every Monday.
Okay, if I do play Gloom, anyway. If I take over his spot for Gloomhaven, they won't get anything done because I'm gonna be a shit.
Gloomhaven's fun.
I'm chaotic. I am chaotic. That is what I am.
That's fine.
Anyway, to cap this off, I hope eventually he starts streaming on his own again. I would definitely support him if he does.
Yeah.
But I'm just whatever he wants to do.
You
do you.
I'm having a really hard time, but I guess I only know him like on a certain level. Like I only know him on the internet. I don't know him in real life.
I'm just having a really hard time
believing that he would do this to his wife, you know? I don't know.
That's the big... I mean, I'm the biggest outsider to all this, but in working with a lot of women who have stories who've had trouble being believed,
yeah,
that I just hear this and hear the type of dynamic because... there is a certain aspect of for someone who has such a certain personality on the internet of just like, oh, how could she do this to him? But yeah. You are absolutely right, Christine. You only know a certain side of...
I only know the guy who's like, who's like dad. He's the internet dad almost. Yeah.
I actually saw supposedly some of the Snapchats he sent to her, like text Snapchats.
Well, and
they are saucy.
Well, and
they
so
are very saucy.
The way this all
text like words.
No. Yeah. Oh, words. Oh, okay. No, yeah. I don't want to see them. I want him to deal with his family. I want her to move on. I don't actually want to be in the drama.
Yeah.
But apparently the way it started was she accidentally sent him a photo of her. Like it wasn't. She said that it wasn't super like. Revealing or anything, but it had like some sass to it, and then he responded a certain way, and then that's how that I mean this is her story that she literally just said that that's how it then transpired. So.
Patrick, yes. Also Nat's comment as well.
Oh, just VGR cast sponsored by browsers. I just want to shout out
my browsers, not browsers.
He just said saucy. Saucy.
Saucy. Saucy. Did I say it in an interesting way?
You said it the Chicago way.
No, you said it very saucy.
Oh, sorry. The Chicago way would be saucy.
Saucy.
Yeah.
The Chicago way is you say, hey, that has a lot of sass.
Like Lindsay said, little sausage.
Sausage. Speaking of, this is actually a really good transition. Speaking of sausage, one of my sister or my sister's one of the dogs. They call her a sausage because she used to be real roly poly. We get home or they go home after we celebrate my grandma's birthday, and a dog attacks Cowley, who's sausage. Basically, he gripped her left arm. There's like a really deep puncture wound and then a couple of other puncture wounds. Turns out the owner was aware that their dog was dog aggressive and their toddler let the dog out. So the owner is actually going to pay for like the vet bills and stuff. But like they keep sending pictures of Callie and she's just laying down on the floor. And I'm like, baby, no.
Baby.
And then Jim was like, hey, would you... This is a long shot, but would you be able to watch Callie this weekend? I'm like, if I didn't have my cat, I totally would. She would come into our apartment. She'd sleep in bed with me. But our kitty is a special child who hates small dogs and large dogs and cats.
And humans.
No, she likes humans. She doesn't hiss at humans.
No. Rick only hisses at dogs.
He just judges.
He only hits at dogs and the guy at the shelter who took his balls away.
Well, yeah, I mean...
Specifically?
Balls!
Well, I'm not surgery trained yet. I'm gonna feel like the dogs and cats that know that I was the anesthesiologist while they were getting their stuff tied and taken away. They're going to be like, hey, wait, wait.
Yeah, fuck that guy at that place.
It wasn't the guy specifically. It wasn't the doctor. It was the shelter worker who was checking him in and checking him out. And we were checking him out, and he just hissed at him. And I've never seen him hiss at another
person like, you
like
bitch.
That before.
You bitch! You did this to me!
And he gave... I also I was pissed because I purposely gave them a blanket so that Rickon would have his own blanket, and they put him in another fucking blanket, and I'm like, bruh.
Well, I mean, coming from the med field, the vet med field, like, it... Sometimes the owner's blanket, they don't want it to get it dirty after, like, after procedure, so... he could wake up and accidentally, like, have an accident, and then your blanket would be covered in, like, poop or pee. So.
It's all poop.
I mean, I guess, but.
Yeah, I also understand your side, because when Danny went to the hospital with me, or her hospital with me last Tuesday, because little Miss decided to throw up 3 days in a row and then not eat for an entire day, so I'm just like, can you just look at her? Can we do something about this thing? Blood work's fine. She's good. But I threw my flannel in there and she curled up on it the whole time. I'll send you the photo. Yeah. Kevin could send it if he wants. He could share it to stream if he wants. He probably won't.
Bet.
Okay, so... My coworkers and I say bet a lot to each other now. We're just like, where's the other one? Is it? No, it's not soup. It's cat. There it is. Like a dog comes in and we're like, oh, let's see if it'll be nice today. One of my other coworkers is like, bet.
Nope.
And then actually I have a really weird like connection with doodles, like labradoodles, golden doodles, stuff like that. There was about a month ago,
doodle poodle snoodle.
A doodle came in that was marked for being like marked bite scratch, so bad dog. But like I was with him on the ground, just kind of holding him. He still had the muzzle on just for our safety, but he wasn't thrashing around, which is what he normally does. And my doctor, she's like, or one of my doctors, she was just like, well, you have the touch. And he likes you, so you're going to be his nurse. Touch. And I'm like, okay.
Hold on. Yay, I'm going to... I'm going to...
Do we go for the weather report?
Hold on.
No, he's got to adjust his settings. Because
now here's
he's
Ollie
gonna maybe
with the
pop on.
Ollie?
Hold on. I got to go to myself, just the webcam. Hold on.
Show the picture of the cat.
Hold on. I need to change the setting real quick.
I'm going to pee while you're changing
I could be... I am a disembodied voice. I could be... doing a silly dance, taking off my clothes, nobody would know.
The booty. So Kevin's webcam, the way it is, all you see from the flag behind him is the booty.
Oh wait, I gotta see if
where's the option? There should be an option for only show people with webcams.
Can I like?
Show non-video participants off. There we go.
No, I wanted to go back and get your picture. Whatever.
Turn off your video real quick, Christina, in Discord.
Okay.
Just go to Discord, click stop. Okay, perfect. Come back in. Okay, cool.
Fuck it, we're doing it live.
We're going to have a weather report from California coming in.
Ooh, goody! We get to see if the world's on fire!
Yeah, so Mike...
So in the meantime, Mike died.
Mike, no! Oh, there he is. With a fucking nerd shirt. We lost Mike!
Wait, did you change your shirt?
Me?
Or did we just not see your shirt before this?
We didn't see your shirt.
Ah. The same shirt. It's a Mob Psycho shirt.
Which Kevin says I would like. It's about a demon, also, right?
That's good.
No, he's a... No. He's
Mob Psycho is very good.
He's a...
Mob Psycho is really
he's
good.
A physic.
A psychic.
A physic.
No.
I'm gonna hit you.
Mike, he's a psychic, right?
Yes, he is.
Okay, thank God.
I have season 1 on Blu-ray.
Mike, why were
would
you wearing
prefer
the
crown?
Was it for the Mad King?
Wait, would you prefer
yes,
the anime?
It was for the Mad King,
Mike,
yes.
Mike. Would you recommend the anime or the manga?
Definitely the anime.
Oh, okay.
Because it's the by weird. One. The manga was written by One, who's also the original author of One Punch Man. Mm. And his art is notoriously bad. But
okay, we're going to watch Mob Psycho then.
Yes.
But like, that's after we finish Food Wars.
Yes. He has good panel composition and he writes compelling narrative, but his actual art is kind of shit.
I also just realized there's a new chapter of My Hero out and I haven't read it yet.
Dude, I just got the end of My Villain Academia in the mail today.
Read it. Read it now. I want to talk about it.
So I'm gonna talk.
I have one. Okay, go. Oh. You, Monica. You go. You.
Oh, I was just gonna jack this so I can stop
jack
Kevin
it?
From talking
jack
about it. Jack it. Yeah. But I started watching Seven Deadly Sins recently.
We've
the only response could have been met with.
I don't know.
We've watched it.
We watched the first half of the first season.
We've watched.
I liked what I saw.
We've watched the first half of the first season twice.
Yeah, I liked what I saw.
The first season with me when we were living together.
We started and
we
then
only
you
watched half of it and then you decided to go off on your own.
Got ahead of us.
Shit.
Yeah.
I've been enjoying it.
I love the pig. Oh my god, I love the pig.
The pig has some
what's his name?
Major
it's thing. A ham. Hawk. Is it hawk? It's hawk,
Hawk,
right? Hawk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hawk. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's so cute.
I don't know. I've always been really into any sort of media that has representations of the seven deadly sins, which is probably why I love FMA Brotherhood so much.
Yeah.
And I've been really enjoying their interpretations of the sins, and that's been the most fun part for me.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Like, especially their interpretation of lust. Like, I think that's my favorite so far.
I don't think I saw that character.
Oh, yeah. He's in the... Well, first off, it's a he, which is pretty uncommon in interpretation.
Yeah.
Lust is androgynous. I'm thinking of someone else. Never mind.
Well, I mean, their lust is kind of androgynous, too.
No, I was thinking of
also...
FMA lust. I was like, wait, no. I was thinking of Envy.
She's very femme, that
No, Envy was the one that was lust. Or, Envy was the one that was androgynous. Lust was...
Seven Deadly Sins is lust. Kind of works off of a lust for knowledge rather than a lust for flesh, and I'm really liking that interpretation.
Lust is the little nerdy dude.
Yeah. I really enjoy that take on it. I am here for it. So that's because
I mean, if you like the show, go like the show.
Thank you.
If you like something, just like it.
Don't. I ain't gonna stop you from liking the show.
Let people enjoy things.
But I'm also not gonna say anything good about the show.
Babe, don't drum on
me. I mean, there are parts of it, like, they need to have Meliodas keep his
I got my sticks finally.
Yes, like, I literally used that. I literally cited that in my video on My Hero Academia. I'm like, he just gropes Elizabeth in her sleep.
Yeah.
I'm like,
he's a weirdo.
Not even in her sleep.
He gropes her just... Time. Yeah, he's a weirdo.
I don't really
like him. He's a badass character, but like...
Those Russians.
Huh?
They're talking in the stream about a guy with a
very
risky name.
I'm gonna divert the attention real quick.
Shakir...
The name Hawk reminded me of what happened today during lunchtime. I can drive again.
Fuck the crow.
Oh,
Steve's here. But still,
oh, look at that.
Where's your webcam, bitch?
No, I told him not to put on
no webcam. No, okay, no. Stay.
Because I don't have to change things.
No, because
do you have anything interesting to show? Because I don't want to have to change all my like frames and shit.
Wow, lazy as fuck.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, actually, you could probably jump in.
Live edit. Show the
live edit.
You can jump in.
And while he does the live edit, That is awful. Right.
Oh, God, it's up and down.
Landscape, right now.
Hey! It's a little better.
Still kind of shit, but that's okay.
Oh, God. What is going on?
Turn off your video.
Oh, God, I'm gonna be
He's got shaky cam. Shaky cam.
And yet he's the clearest of all of us right now.
Really is.
Yeah.
And now the weather with Steve. How's the weather out there, Steve?
Yeah, Steve, let us
know. Foggy as fuck.
Is it foggy or smoky?
Foggy, actually. We're in Crescent City. In Northern California right now.
Oh, yeah!
We just spent all day yesterday and most of today in Oregon, and we're back in California now.
Oregon.
So it's not on fire.
It actually, we saw a ton of burn shit. I'll share some pictures some other time. But everything, we didn't see any active fires, but it's been smoky as shit the entire time we've been here. So.
Yeah, I mean, wildfires.
The damn liberal media made me believe the entire state was burned down.
Well, the entire state is.
Have you met a man named Dan down. So that you can say that Dan is not on fire?
No.
No one gets that reference. Okay.
I get it. It's one of the British dudes.
Christine, I figured you would get it. Okay.
And then PJ.
But Matt wants to know, Steve, if you went to the Mystery Shack in Oregon.
I don't know. I'll have to ask Vanessa what the hell that is, though. I don't think I did.
But who started the fire, though?
Oregon, so.
It's apparently a Gravity Falls reference.
I have never been to I've never seen Gravity Falls. I've heard it's good, and I need to put it on my list.
He's got it good.
That is what Christine and I say too. Never seen it. Want to see it?
What?
Yeah. Watch it.
Gravity Falls.
Oh yeah.
You guys have Disney Plus. There's nothing stopping you.
There are about a dozen other shows we have to watch.
We have to finish Supernatural. We have to finish Legend of Korra.
We're almost done. We're almost done with Supernatural.
My manager mentioned Supernatural at work today.
It's so good.
We're so close to the end.
So good.
Yeah.
At this point,
right.
I'm
apparently Beth watches Supernatural.
At this point, I'm just finishing out of spite. I think it's okay.
Supernatural is like if I ever manage to get through the entire watch list on my phone, which is quite lengthy. Not even just with the anime. That Supernatural will be the last thing that I watch.
What, Mike?
How many seasons are there? Like
15.
15.
Oh my god.
And 15. Each season's 24 episodes long. Each episode is at
like
least 48 40
minutes
long.
Minutes.
No.
Yes.
Yeah. It's a lot.
Okay. Here's the real thing. We've been watching this show for almost as long as we've been dating.
Yes.
Wow.
I've heard good things about Milo Murphy's
Which is about
Law.
8 years coming June.
This show has existed for over half our lifetimes.
Yes.
Shut up.
Sarah, I've heard good things about Milo Murphy's Law. Or Milo Murphy's Law.
I know. Yeah,
I remember Supernatural being talked about when Smallville was a thing.
Yeah, Smallville was a thing.
I forgot about Smallville.
My cousin Dan really loves Smallville because it's about Superman.
Why hasn't the Smallville fandom persisted?
Because
like,
it's
I've never
dead.
Heard anything bad. Yeah, but I've never heard anything bad about it. So like,
well, the show's gone. So they're like, oh, I guess I gotta find a different show.
I guess.
I think somewhat recently, like the CW did Crisis on Infinite Earths, which is like a classic, like superhero story from like the 70s and 80s. And I'm pretty sure that it like involves like multiverses and stuff.
I don't even think it's that old.
What?
I don't think Crisis on Infinite Earth is that old.
It is.
Is it?
Yes. It involves like multiverse stuff, and I'm pretty sure they brought in the dude who plays Superman.
Publication dates April 1985 to March 1986.
So it's before us.
Yeah, way before we were born. But it was basically it took like Superman had all these really dumb powers, and all the superheroes existed in like separate universes. Basically, it took them all the DC separate universes and smooshed them all into one and kind of retconned everything else.
So it's Future Wars.
Your Future
essentially
Wars.
Future Wars is the Marvel equivalent of like. Secret Wars. Was it Secret Wars or Future Wars? I don't remember.
Secret Wars sounds more familiar.
I think it's Secret Wars. Secret Wars essentially, Doctor Doom gets his hands on, I think it might be the Infinity Gauntlet, and he makes... Essentially, Dr. Doom, there's this cosmic event that's happening, and he uses it to his advantage, and he makes all these universes collide, and he becomes God King Doom.
Fun fact, Secret Wars was in publication a year before Crisis on Infinite Earths.
There's like several different versions of it. I know which one Kevin's talking about. The one Kevin's talking about is more recent. I actually read most of some, if not most of it, and it was actually really interesting. I enjoyed that run.
The original Secret Wars was a 12 issue series from starting in 1980.
Yeah. So all I know is Secret Wars. Sorry, I'm just on this button real quick. Secret Wars is pretty much the only logical next step for the Marvel Universe, I think, because that's how they can smush in the X-Men universe and the Fantastic Four universe. That's how they can smush them all together real nicely.
Yeah, for sure. What were you saying, Monica?
So so this is the perfect opportunity to introduce one of the things I wanted to bring up. So Nat and I were just yesterday we pulled up just a random Red Letter Media to watch before bed because we were just like it's too late to get started on anything but too early to quite go to bed. So he pulled it up and he pulls up this random episode of Best of the Worst, and they had Freddie Williams on as one of the guests, who I guess is a writer for, or not a writer, an illustrator for a bunch of comics within the last decade or so. And Nat just turns to me and they have him as a guest for some reason. And Nat just turns to me, he's like, "This is Kevin." And I'm like,
"No, I was literally about to say, I pulled up a picture while you were talking about him. I'm like, oh my God, he looks like Kevin."
Yeah, especially with the picture. Like,
I'm going to I'm going to the picture.
It's you.
I am Phantom Drummering. It's what I do.
Oh my God.
It does look like pretty shocking. Like,
it's you. It's you.
That's how you Phantom Drum.
You
just wave your six flailing in the air.
You
shoulder boy,
I looked at the picture of him like signing autographs or something.
Yeah, and when watching the episode, like, it's not just the picture. Like, watching the episode, I'm just like, the more I watch him, the more I see it. But apparently he was an illustrator for Seven Soldier on the comic series Robin, and on the Eisner Award-winning Seven Soldiers, Mr. Miracle. He's done a lot of crossover, including Batman, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, He-Man, Thundercats, Justice Master of the Universe. I think
I don't want to see just your. Oh.
I think he did stuff with Star-Lord, too.
Yeah. That's what the Wikipedia page is saying.
No, you got to tilt your head the other way, babe.
Apparently,
trust me, I'm looking at my stream and I'm looking the right way.
And then turn.
Apparently, he did a Batman Ninja Turtles crossover. I am more face onto the camera.
Yeah,
there you go. Yeah, there you go. Oh, that's perfect.
Oh, God. Yes, that guy does look like me. I saw you posted it on the Facebook, and I was like, oh, God, yeah. I'm fine. He's a good-looking dude. That's fine.
Today. He's a good-looking dude, says the guy who looks like him.
Yeah.
I don't know
fuck
if you're
Mike.
Aware, Steve, but from fifth grade through sophomore year, or through sophomore year to junior year of college, I was a percussionist. But then ISU had to be dumb and do traditional grip, and I don't know how to play traditional grip. I only know match grip because that's what my high school taught me. And I knew that I wasn't gonna be good enough to be snare, so then I decided to be cymbals. But yes, I've always been...
Loud noises.
I thought drummers just had to count to four.
Actually, we got to count to 16.
One, two, three, one.
So
two,
fuck off.
Three, one, two, three.
One, two, three.
No, thanks, so while we were celebrating my grandma's birthday this weekend, I took these sticks and then...
Uh-oh.
Pegged Kevin.
Big-ass bag of sticks.
That is an excessive amount.
You pegged
Wait,
Kevin
can I have
that?
Two?
No.
I like to drum on things. Can I have two?
They're hers.
Can I just have two?
No!
Kevin, there's only one way those things are touching your body, and it's not going to weigh your, like... Well, maybe you will like it. Who knows?
You can't know me, Mike.
You can't have
you know what I'm about.
That's what I said. I was like, maybe you will like it. Who knows?
But yeah,
it's 2020, Mike. Man can like getting pegged.
I have entirely too many sticks and no drum to play them with.
We should get...
Have you seen Kevin?
Let's get an electronic drum pad.
I have a drum pad somewhere.
No, an electronic one.
You're an electronic drum pad.
They sell electronic drum pads. It's like Kevin's four. It's
he
like,
is an IT guy, so.
He is an electronic drum pad.
Drum on this booty.
Hey-o. That's the whole fucking joke, dummies.
I've never seen a drummer insert the stick into the drum, though, so.
Oh! I got a story for you.
I don't like that you needed that statement to lead off.
Okay. Back in high school, we did lots of dumb shit as drummers, as we all do. We were at band camp. So we were at a rival school, and we were there as like pep band, and we kept throwing the stick and then having it bounce off the ground to hit the snare drum. Section leader, gonna call him Matt, he did it, and then it went through the head of the snare drum.
Oh,
and we're just like, oh, okay, so Matt doesn't get to play for the rest of the day. and we hit it from our director until we got back to school. And he's like, how did this happen? And we were like,
I don't know. Mystery.
Well, yeah, no, because he didn't know. He doesn't check. He never checked the drums every time we would bring them back and put them away. And we made sure to put that drum away relatively quickly. But then we had homecoming coming up. And then Matt was kind of like, all right, we actually need to fix this. I should probably let him know. So then, I think it was like a week or two later. And then we got it fixed, but my band...
Yeah, drum heads are not hard to replace.
No, but my band director's like, how did this happen? And we were just like... We were playing too hard. And he was just looking at us like, I'm not a percussionist, but I know that's a shit excuse. Because we would have had to play like this. Which is not what percussionists do. Shut up. This is what we do.
I don't know. I've seen Trey Cool play, so.
Trey Cool ain't a fucking drummer.
Ooh. Yeah. Them's fight
words. Fight me.
Wow.
Fight me. You want to know,
Who Trey Cool is, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
You want to know who's a real drummer? forgot his name.
Not Eddie Van Halen.
May he rest.
Oh.
No shit. What's his fucking name?
I had to transition to it somehow.
No. Eddie's. No.
You made me sad again.
Nick Cannon's a real drummer. Okay, can I really...
Who the fuck talks about Nick Cannon anymore?
Can I quickly just rant about the movie Drumline, please? Please.
Smack it.
Go for it, my girl.
Harder.
So, fun fact, Nick can't play for shit. Every close-up you see of him playing the drums is another person. And it's actually a white guy playing. Because his hands are white. And we're just kind
of
like...
So it's literally that gif of where, like, the white guy goes to shake the black guy's hand and then it cuts to the close-up and it's two white hands. It's literally that gif.
Mm-hmm. And it's like, the only reason I'll ever watch Drumline is if I'm drunk and I'm just like, oh, I need to relive shit. And it's so... Oh my god, the whole premise is he can't read music, and you can't... No! It's not how it works!
To be fair, my dad couldn't read music, and he was in a band for like 5 years, so...
That's different. But I thought you were going to say, to be fair, percussionists can't read music, and I was about to shit on you.
Well, also that.
Excuse me!
You just count to four and repeat!
No! There's syncopation, you gotta do paradiddles, you gotta match sticks, you gotta do a bunch of shit that's harder than fucking blowing through a instrument.
Did someone die while I was on vacation?
Yeah, Eddie Van Halen died today.
To be fair, my phone has been on airplane mode since like 9 a.m. this morning.
Yeah, it was literally today, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, I try not to burn through my battery, and I know I'm not going to have any cell towers near Crater Lake, so I'm so...
You're going to Crater Lake! I hate it! I love Crater Lake! It's so pretty! I want to live there.
I feel like
it's
I...
So pretty. Unfortunately, it's super hazy, but it was still gorgeous.
It's like the prettiest lake in the world. Yeah. Lake Tacoma is the prettiest lake in the world.
Lake Tahoe, you mean?
Yes! Fuck off! I can't. Words. Ever.
No, it's fine.
Kevin? This is your podcast. Why are you not talking?
I'll be sure to post pictures or send pictures to the group chat later.
Yeah. You know, I totally wasn't reading the new My Hero chapter.
Shut up.
What? Are you really
Mike knows what's happening right now.
So many chapters behind. Shut the fuck up.
Mike knows what I'm dealing with right now. Just don't like it.
This is some unprofessional ass shit,
Kevin. Anyway, well, there was something happening that I didn't really care about that much.
Anyway, maybe it's just because I'm a shitty millennial, uncultured millennial, but the only Eddie Van Halen I'm familiar with is when he did the guitar solo for Beat It. Did you not know he did that?
Yeah.
The legend is Michael Jackson song Beat It. He did the guitar and he did it in one take because he fucking hated Michael Jackson.
He walked into the recording studio, did it, walked out.
Yeah.
Why did he hate Michael Jackson?
Because he was a pop star and Eddie Van Halen didn't like pop music.
That's fair, I guess.
To be fair, like, if Michael Jackson was alive today and he did all that music today, it wouldn't be pop. Like, no. He'd be very alt or alt rock.
Yeah.
Traditional grip is left hand.
He'd be a very alt.
Some of his later stuff would be pop, but not anything from Thriller, that would be like alt.
Like Beat It, very alt rock.
Just Beat It.
If your song has a guitar solo, it's probably alt rock.
Ozzy Osbourne.
Ozzy Osbourne's rock.
Borderline metal.
Yeah.
Crazy Train is the best song. You cannot be wrong.
Crazy Train.
When, oh god, I can't think of what the thing is called. The particular percussion thing that you kind of hit against your side and it makes up the. Because we had one of those because in high school, because we did Crazy Train as a pep.
Oh! Mm-hmm. Oh, that thing. Oh.
Yes.
You know I just called it the noisemaker. Yes. I didn't actually know the real name for it.
That might have actually been what my director called it.
That's 100% what my director called it.
Yeah, I think we all fucking called it the noisemaker. Let me see.
Hold on, let me see.
Yeah,
instrument that goes.
Instrument.
Nat, we'll talk about the Trump corona thing later.
Ratchet.
Yeah, maybe? No, it wasn't the ratchet.
No, not a ratchet.
Might have been the ratchet.
Because the ratchet goes...
Was it the lock?
No, it was a wooden block with a little ball on the end, and you hit it against...
No, I know exactly what it is.
It's a vibra slap.
No. Maybe it is.
Yeah, the wood block...
Oh, shit, yeah, it's a vibra... Okay,
yeah, it's a vibra slap.
Fuck you.
Vibra slap.
With Mark Shelton. Percussion How To, vibra slap with Mark Shelton.
Call it a vibra slap, though. That's too many
it's
words.
This video is from 2011.
That's because that's what it's called. It's a vibra slap.
No, yeah. Just like,
Is three syllables too much for you, Steve? It's the same amount as noisemaker.
Have you heard me try to speak things, man?
Always.
Pushing it, man.
Can you fucking go there?
Sentence, yeah.
What?
Have you heard me try to speak things?
I don't does the English good. Kevin, are you reading anime again?
Yes, he is.
Leave me alone.
Kevin, get off your
is
phone.
Is he reading anime again?
He is.
Crawl in a hole and die.
He's fucking...
I'm sorry. Reading manga.
I've only got a few pages left.
Christine, confiscate his phone.
Oh my god, Kevin. Come on.
Nice.
This is your fucking podcast. Give me your goddamn phone.
Turn around and read it, and then come back.
Okay, hold on.
We'll talk about how much of a fucking loser you are while you're gone.
I'm gonna put it on the stream manager. There we go. Now it's on stream manager.
I don't know what that means, but I'm just going to call you a nerd, and we're going to talk about how much
manager.
While you're reading the My Hero chapter.
I have his phone. This is his phone. It's coming over by me.
Oh,
so
you took his phone away from him like a teacher?
Like a fucking child, yes.
But it was
no anime until after school, young Kevin. Or no manga until after school, young Kevin.
I was using that for stream.
Go back to writing your comic books.
No.
Danny? Where?
Danny! What the fuck?
So now that I don't have my phone, I'm going to talk about My Hero.
No, if you talk about I'm not caught up
so
at all.
So currently what's happening right now
is... asshole! I'm going to tell everyone to unsubscribe to you.
I censored it. We're okay.
You can't censor life.
Yeah, oh, wait. Here we go.
I can get a
I see her tail flicking in your camera. Oh, Nat gives you Rickon, and he's like, uh-oh.
That's the ultimate sensor.
Rickon looks big.
He is.
Is he a chonky?
Is he working on his computer now?
Oh, no, right. He's a long boy.
Long boy.
So I was actually talking to my coworker today. I was like, I wish, because they can do wisdom panels, basically DNA panels at my company for dogs. And I'm like, I wish there was a wisdom panel for a cat so I could know what the fuck she is. Because, like, she looks like a Burmese cat, but she also looks like a Havana Brown.
She's for sure hypoallergenic because I don't really have much of a reaction to her at all.
No,
an old cat.
Yes, we know she's an old cat. She's also shedding her fur like crazy.
Can you get the treat box? Well, I can get the treat box. It's fine.
Good, because I'm tucking.
Good, because I'm tucking.
Are you going to
read My Hero on the microwave while he's gone? Don't let him.
We're on a diet. He can't go to the microwave. But actually, I'm on camera. Her treats are on the nightstand in between the two table things. Nope. The chair and the couch.
I don't know what to do with this, Rickon. It's not a
nightstand. Whatever, it's a fucking end table.
Until he does not want to be held anymore.
His tail says no, but he's not moving.
Oh, you smell like venison. You smell like
food. His tail says no, but his eyes say, go fuck yourself.
Is My Hero hunter-gatherer?
Hey, Mike. Does this smell good to you?
I can't smell anything through the microphone.
I don't want to talk about
that joke?
It. No, explain it.
Oh, then we can talk about the weekend. Hold on. Good intro.
Oh, yeah. So, we kidnapped Ryan this weekend.
Yeah, we did.
Ow.
So, it was...
okay.
That's a residual effect from the kidnapping.
So, it was Ryan's last shift at Meijer on Saturday.
And then
Christine, Mike, and I were like, because we were already hanging out, and we were like,
well, we were trying to get him since the beginning of the day to just call off sick.
Just call off sick. But then
we were trying to get him to do it from like 2 days before that day.
And then we were kind of like, should we go kidnap him? We can go kidnap him. Yeah. And then so.
And then it was like an hour and a half of Facebook Messenger.
Being like,
asking
hey,
for consent to
can
kidnap
we kidnap
him?
You?
Yeah, like, we were literally like, all right, can we actually do this? And half the time he was like, oh, yeah, totally, sure.
His response was, if you're kidnapping me, I don't think it's in my hands. I'm like, that's not an answer.
And then so we went to Meijer.
Kidnapping someone, I don't think the party being kidnapped needs to give you consent. I
mean, well, we didn't want to literally kidnap you. But
so,
anyway, I'm
so
sorry,
then we went to Meijer, and then we're walking around.
Did someone pay for a treat?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then immediately we saw Ryan, and like we were like, "Is that Ryan? I don't know if that's Ryan. It's hard to tell because he's wearing the same clothes as everyone else."
Yeah, we literally could not tell from the back if it was Ryan or not.
Yeah. And then we.
I
and
could.
Then we,
I know what Ryan looks like from the back.
Yeah. He looks presentable.
We. Ooh, presenting.
It's called presenting.
We walked around. Hey, We walked around and we bought duct tape and rope.
Well, we were going to buy it.
Well, we were just finding it.
Find a rope.
We found rope.
We found rope. Duct tape,
It was the first thing we found, actually.
The arts and crafts section, Ryan. God. Yeah.
I don't work over there.
Anyway,
we noticed.
You were pretty close to it.
Apparently,
yeah, you, were right
you
there.
Work with the fishes? What?
Apparently,
the guy who works in gardening needs to have a call about
from
fish.
From the electronics department.
Oh, to clarify that, they put me wherever they fucking need me.
Okay. Mm-hmm. But still, the electronics department was like, hey, we need you to go put fish somewhere. What?
No, that's not, okay, what? Someone wanted to get goldfish.
That's okay. So they asked the electronics company?
At 8 p.m. No, it was the guy in electronics who called me.
Okay.
But someone needed goldfish at 8 p.m. on a Saturday.
That's either a really high dude or really distressed mother.
Well, but then long story short, Ryan faked a hernia.
Yeah.
Well, okay. To be fair, he had a hernia in the past, or he still has it, whatever. But he faked it injuring him.
It was a very convincing performance.
So that we got to the car and I was like, Ryan, are you actually okay?
And like, I'm like,
you
yes,
okay?
You shithead. He's an actor. He can act. He's an actor.
Sarah says, hi, Mom.
As the actor of the group, I am proud.
Oh, no, I was convinced.
Yeah, you just seen it.
Yeah.
I was convinced Ryan was actually in pain.
You need to upload those clips somewhere.
He was like,
I can't. I need to edit them first.
Just censor your mask and you'll be fine.
Oh, yeah. You do got to blur that. No, so we get Ryan into the car. Like, we were walking across.
Mike's my editor now.
Shut up. While we were walking across the parking lot, I put my hand on his back, you know, be comforting and all that bullshit. And then Ryan gets in the back of the seat, still like this. And then Kevin's like, are you okay? He's like, yeah, go fucking drive.
Drive.
I'm like, yeah, he's acting, you idiot.
The plot twist, though, was he had actually sent us a message before we entered the store going,
I need y'all to be serious.
Sick. Please take this seriously. We're walking around the store talking about a fucking kidnapping, collecting duct tape and yarn.
And actually, hey, I did something kind. I was going to buy him. I was gonna buy him contact solution. I was being nice.
No, the best part was right at the end
you actually needed contact solution.
Yeah, he did.
So why do you picked it up?
Oh, me? No, I don't have contacts.
right at the end when Ryan approached us with his supervisor, we were in the Halloween section, like, playing with Minecraft swords.
And then Ryan comes
up. Me and Mike were, like, hitting each other with Minecraft swords.
And then, I have the hoodie up with the ears flopping.
No, and then Ryan comes up and says, like, can we go now, guys?
Like, oh yeah, sure, let's go. Like, okay, guess we're doing it. Because they were walking towards us, and I was like, is there like an employee door back here that he needs to go through?
No, I thought
we just walk into his path of direction.
I thought that we were gonna get in trouble. I don't know. I was like,
what are they gonna do? Kick us out of Meyer?
The supervisor that I was with, she likes to call people, like, call security on people like that are just digging around. So
that's bullshit. Good thing you don't work there anymore.
We are done.
I want my dog. I want my cat.
Nat.
Is he nipping at you? Rickon, no nipping. Nico, did you look at me?
I'm done.
He's like, no, I want. He's like, I want Papa.
Yes, we gotta give high fives.
And you went to my Papa's. Oh, he's so freaking cute. Oh, but yeah, so Danny weighed in at like 5.8 pounds, and I'm like, you're so tiny. You lost a pound. I'm sad.
Yeah, Rickon is probably double that.
Most cats should be double that. Well, she's also just slight in build anyway, but she's also...
Sarah says...
Does Nat just
want to
join the stream? What's going on?
He just wants to give Rickon high fives.
Then take the cat and give him high fives.
You an invitation to join.
No.
Oh, really?
No.
Yes. Nope. Wait. Really? Yes, no, maybe. No. Yes, no, maybe so. The most vague answer I could give.
Bye, Rickon.
What Bye. if I have Nat with Rickon?
Future unsure.
No, I'll go.
Ask again later. In like 2 minutes. Give me my cat. Are you itching your ears? If you're itching your ears, guess what? We're going to have to start cleaning them again.
She was itching her ear.
All right.
Speaking of Minecraft, though.
We need to check her ears.
Steve is confirmed for Minecraft.
Steve! You're in Minecraft, buddy!
Steve confirmed for Minecraft. Steve, what's it like to be, like, in the limelight with people like Kirby and
Mario
and Mario?
I was on the Kirby Reddit, I was on the Kirby Wiki for way too long the other day.
Dude, I follow a Kirby bot on Twitter, and it's the most wholesome, weird shit ever.
Also, for context, earlier before the stream started, I was so excited about Minecraft Steve being in Smash that I was like, I know hey, Steve is confirmed for Minecraft. And everyone's like, you're an idiot. I'm like, yes.
Oh, I actually don't hate it. I don't hate it.
So, okay.
So what does he do? Does he drop creepers? I don't, we've never played as Steve. I don't get it. Does he drop creepers? So what does he do?
Well, he probably has a...
building and stuff. Yeah. Like, there's like a,
It seems like he's going to be a lot of, he's going to be a big ability-based character. Like, he can drop anvils on people. He can build mine carts and run people over. He can upgrade his sword. I think his base attack is a sword, but like he can like dig for resources and like upgrade his sword, and like
progression character.
What's
the
smash?
Yeah, his smash is I think he summons a giant piston and just pushes everyone in front of him.
So I got a question. I couldn't really tell from the trailer. Is it more than just Steve? Because I saw Alex. I saw a zombie.
I think those are just skins.
Yeah, I think the way they're treating, I'm going to assume the way they're treating that is like how the Koopa kids are treated.
Yeah.
Okay. Why is like, his smash not summoning a super?
That's fair.
Well, actually, I don't know because they did show off something where, so I think what it is he summons a giant piston, and if you get caught in it, you get pushed off screen, and then there's a little cinematic that plays where like you're put into like a little cave. Where, like, a bunch of creepers show up, and they surround you, and they all explode. And then you take a ton of damage.
Should we talk about that, too? The Minecraft update?
Oh, fuck! Caves and cliffs?
This is literally Minecraft 2.0.
And they're revamping everything.
So we're starting a new vanilla server, right?
When that launches, it's not launching until 2021. But when that launches, we are 100% starting a vanilla server.
Dude, the warden terrifies me.
Oh, so,
Oh, you getting square me.
I learned more about the warden, Mike. So,
oh, really?
Apparently, so there's one of the new underground biomes is, like, this, like, weird, like, kind of, like, void biome. Where that's where, like, the weird, like, blue fungus stuff spawns. And apparently the warden only spawns there. Mm-hmm. There's also, like, a lot of really good loot down there. Apostle apparently also he doesn't see, like he can't see,
which but he can hear you.
He can hear you, yes, but you can throw snowballs and stuff just to distract
like
him.
Just like that Let's Play we watched on Sunday. I can hear you open every door.
Wow, you exist.
Oh, Baldi's.
Baldi.
I watched the speed run of that.
So essentially, the new Minecraft update, Caves and Cliffs, is like the next big update. It's 1.17. It's gonna pretty much revamp a lot of things. Like, it's gonna change the way the overworld spawns. Mountains will actually now be mountains. Like, they'll look really cool. Caves will be more dynamic. Like, they'll be more like wide open areas with like big pillars of stone in the middle and waterfalls.
Totally,
and like
you to be like, and caves will be like caves. Like,
they're gonna be more like caves, though. They're gonna be cavier. Caves get cavier.
This is as close to a Minecraft 2 as we're probably going
to
get.
Yeah, they're adding copper ore. They're adding axles, or what did I say that?
Axolotls.
Axolotls that apparently can be tamed.
Are fucking adorable.
Apparently you can tame them, and then they can go into battle with you. There's mountain goats now that'll kick you off mountains.
The glow squid they added.
Glow squid. There's a new underground lush cavern biome. God, it's just going to be like the coolest. It's going to be a really, really fucking big update. And I thought the Nether update was big. But like, this is like, I'm just kind of like floored because they keep putting out free updates. I'm like, at any point they could just go, oh, we're dropping a Minecraft 2, and I'd be a total idiot and buy it again. Because I'm a sucker for Minecraft.
Has Overwatch 2 come out yet?
No.
That's a thing.
Not for a while.
Unfortunately, yes.
Nice
thing though about Overwatch 2 is that like it's not required to buy it, because if you already have Overwatch, like you still get all the maps, you still get all the new characters,
and great.
And you can still crossplay with everyone. The only difference is Overwatch 2 will have a full story mode. So you're really buying Overwatch 2 for the full story mode.
To buy it, because I
yeah.
Play. story mode.
Like I'm kind of like, yeah, I'd fucking play an Overwatch story mode. Like, I'd 100% play an Overwatch
story
mode.
So when are we doing Drunker Watch?
Mike, I am down for Drunker Watch whenever you want.
Did we talk about... Have we talked about Content Brain on the podcast
yet? No, we haven't, but we're about to.
No. So, yeah, let me talk. So, me and... I first discussed this with Ryan, and then I brought it up with Kevin. So, me and Kevin have what is called Content Brain. Me, the YouTuber, him, the Twitch streamer. Where we will see something and go, that would make good content. Let's do that. And then the people who are not stupid look at that and go, that sounds awful. Why would we do that? Like, Halo Lasso would be a good example of that. See, Steve, you're the one who's not stupid.
Which, by the way, so... Mike, tomorrow, since Steve's not here, do you want to start Halo 1 Lasso? Halo 1 Lasso, Mike.
Yes.
Halo 1 Lasso. We can do it.
Do it.
Yes.
Today, tomorrow's stream has been decided live on the podcast.
We're going to hate each other. Yeah.
Yay.
So, yeah. So that's what, if you ever hear us mention Content Brain, that's it. Like, Content Brain, like, anytime playing Overcooked, that's Content Brain.
Yeah. Oh, God. What are the Halo 1 skulls even?
I don't know. Ryan, what?
Pretty much the same thing, really.
Okay. Yeah.
Good, oh good.
Oh my god. Dude, Content Brain is the best.
Or the worst.
Or the worst. For you guys, it's the worst.
So, this weekend...
Where did Christine go? I'm going to need to clip that and like share it on Twitter or something. Talk about Content
Brain. Take care of the Danny Roo.
Christine, where'd you go? I'm cleaning the cat's ears. Oh, she's cleaning the cat's ears.
Yes, I was about to say. She was talking about Danny's ears right before. So,
oh,
I know I had brought this up, but my sister and her boyfriend were over on Sunday, and we showed them Suburban Sasquatch.
What's Suburban Sasquatch?
Horrible.
Is it a movie?
Yes, it is. It is a movie? Question mark. It's horrible, but it is a thing of beauty to watch, just to see how terrible it is and just all of the terrible design choices that happened with this movie.
So is it one of those movies that's deliberately terrible, or we tried to make it we tried to make a good movie and just did everything wrong?
It has a 3.3 on IMDb.
The latter. Where
oh,
they're,
no.
They,
that's
really,
the best kind
like,
of terrible movie.
That it is glorious, and I don't know if you heard Nat there making the "aww" noise. That's literally how the monster sounds.
to be fair, on IMDb, it's listed as a video and not a movie.
Oh God, that's a whole nother thing, but it is a. It is a treat to watch, and there's something new you find every time you watch it.
Oh my god, you can watch it on Amazon Video.
Oh no.
Also, her left ear was worse.
Which is why Nat's comment in the chat, caves will have tarps on them, because the caves, they have these cave scenes, and they're literally just tarps with CGI rocks.
Oh god.
Oh.
CGI.
Also,
oh my.
Mike, one of the skulls in Halo 1 is we can't pick up Covenant weapons.
Sucks.
I don't think I would be bothered by, well, except for the plasma pistol. I don't think I'd be bothered by that.
Yeah, but my thing is the fact that like we'll be in like the middle of a Covenant level.
I'm
and,
sorry,
like,
but your ears were
oh,
dying.
No,
nothing
please,
to,
no.
You have nothing
no.
to pick up.
Kevin Keyes is gonna die so many times.
Yeah.
Is Danny?
We're gonna fund tomorrow, Mike.
She's mad because I cleaned her ears.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh wait, you might get that far.
Oh, that's a big mood. Rickon is the.
We're not gonna get that far.
I tried to clip his nails. Who boy?
Oh, she's good. She's good for me. But
he is so bad with that. Like I have learned to kind of just like. Deal with the pain and just be like, okay,
at least you're a pet owner that tries. Most of the pet cat owners I know don't.
I try because it hurts if I don't.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Kevin,
the way my friend M deals with her feisty cat is that she wraps him up in a big blanket and then pulls 1 foot out at a time.
That's called a cat burrito, and that is actually taught in vet tech.
My dad used to do that with one of our cats a lot when I was younger.
With which one? The black cat?
Yeah. No, it's an older cat who.
Oh.
Do you?
I know the itch.
Really?
No.
Really cat story.
I know the story.
You know the story.
Do it.
Should I?
Do it.
So. The first cat I remember having, his name was Spike. Real big tomcat looking dude. Towards the end of his life, he was basically just letting loose, just shitting everywhere. It's okay, I think we have to put the cat down. So we put the my mom did that, and so, but this is really horrible, by the way. I want to brace you for what happens. So we put the cat down, and the vet said, do you want us to bury it for you? And my mom said, no, we can take care of it.
Oh.
Not only did she not bury it, she left it outside in the winter for a little while. So thankfully it didn't decompose. But eventually she just threw it away in the garbage.
That's why we offer cremation services.
Yeah. Literally, the vet was like, do you want us to get rid of the body for you? And my mom's like, no, we'll do it.
But she didn't.
I'm upset.
Yeah.
I'm
12-year-old cat.
And that's not even old for a cat. 12 isn't old for a cat.
12 is when my Bootsy died.
Oh, you... growling?
I'd say over 10, you're about, you should expect.
Are you growling at me? Excuse me, are you growling at me?
Rip, rip yeah. Your boy Boots.
Hang on, one sec.
Yeah, I mean.
My boy Boots was, he was my childhood kitty growing up, and he was a gray tuxedo kitty with white boots, and he was the best.
He tried to steal our bacon. Yeah.
Oh, that's just you breathing.
Oh my god. That cat loved bacon.
No, I felt a deep vibration.
I mean, to be fair,
baby.
Good
Spike vibration. Lived longer than our other cat, Panda, who had feline leukemia. So that's
feline leukemia sucks.
Pet cancer is
just a cruel. No. Feline. Okay. Yeah. Feline leukemia is not cancer.
I actually had adopted
leukemia is
cat
cancer.
From my
feline leukemia is not cancer.
No. Leukemia is not cancer.
No.
I thought leukemia is cancer.
Technically, no.
Look at the tail. Jackson. She's so mad.
I don't.
Babies.
The leukemia
has
cancer.
Something to do with the lymph nodes, I think.
Leukemia is a cancer of the white blood cell.
Oh my god. Feline leukemia is not cancer.
It isn't?
No. It's a virus. Feline leukemia virus is a disease that only affects cats. It cannot be transmitted to people, dogs, or other animals. FELV is passed from one cat to another through saliva, blood,
fine,
and
but I'm
extent.
Saying that leukemia is a cancer.
Right, you're okay.
It's the cancer that Ben died in Scrubs.
Yes.
Sad-ass episode.
That is a sad-ass episode.
Watch Scrubs,
God, Steve's face!
Sorry, hold on.
Oh, God!
Oh, God!
I'm plugging my phone
in. Isn't, what's that? Who's the actor? The actor?
Brandon Fraser?
Yeah. Isn't he supposed to be in something soon, or is he? I thought I saw something. No? Well,
I need Brendan Fraser and,
he's the best mummy.
Never mind.
Whoever played Ava.
No.
He's doing a TV show right now called Doom Patrol for DC.
He's in Doom Patrol. Yeah.
Oh. But I haven't watched it. I want to though.
What were we just talking about?
Cats.
Dead cats. So let's not go back to that.
My cat's alive. Her tail's twitching.
He is very upset. So one is she. Of
damn it.
Oh, Rickon's upset too. Nat.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna bite you, mother. Mother, I'm biting you.
So they literally just made he plays a robot in Doom Patrol.
He gets
squirmy. Robot man.
He likes it when you hold him like baby better.
Oh, Patrick's grandma's cat got COVID.
Yeah.
Feline coronavirus.
COVID can spread.
Can get COVID.
Yeah, COVID can spread to your pets from you, and you can catch it from them.
Apparently,
no one is fucking safe.
Also had COVID
yeah.
Now.
Oh my god.
Pretty much.
Oh, that's the thing we'll talk about in a few minutes. Yeah.
I don't want to talk about him. I hate him.
I've
got some great tweets to pull up, though.
I
agree with that sentence.
Whenever the food gets here, I'm gonna bow out. So just so you guys know.
I agree with your exact sentiment, child.
I sent a picture of Brendan Fraser, by the
Vanessa
way. Oh, I need a movie with Brendan Fraser and Nathan Fillion.
Yes.
That's not the crossover I would expect.
But it's a crossover.
Brendan Fraser did not age well.
No, he didn't.
No.
But he also.
Neither did fucking Bill Murray.
Well, he had a lot of shit happen to him in the early 2010s.
Bill Murray's also just old.
How old is Bill?
Let's see.
70-something, I'd wager.
I'm going to guess late 60s.
Easy. Easy 70s.
70.
So we.
Oh, 70. Yep.
Okay, 70 even.
He's from Evanston.
Yeah, I just saw that. That's why he's a Cubs fan.
And also, the fucking Murray restaurants.
Yes.
What?
I've never been to those.
There's a couple Murrays.
We went to one. It was great.
It was okay.
It was, it was great for the fact that it was a celebrity.
The food was okay. We're pretty sure we saw one of his brothers there.
His only brother, I think.
Brian?
I don't fucking know.
Brian Murray.
We talked about Smash Bros. We talked about Minecraft.
Do we want to get political now?
No. Well.
Yeah, I know Bill Murray's at least two brothers. We saw one of them.
I typed in Bill Murray brother, and Google gave me like 5 search results.
Anyway, so Trump got COVID.
Woo.
He's fine now.
Here's the thing. He's not fine. They pumped him full of antibiotics, and he's just gonna ride it out.
Like, state of the art.
Yeah. So I don't know how this tweet's gonna play on. That's perfect. So I'm playing on the stream right now a clip of that someone took of like him like standing in front of the White House like kind of struggling to catch his breath. Yeah, like. Like, you could tell this man is in distress. Like, he's like...
Nope, I'm in distress. Oh my god, that's a lot of distress.
It's like, bro, take a fucking week, man. We get it. We get it. It's fucking COVID.
Literally every politician and every news outlet was like, yeah, we're not going to bash on Trump this week because you're... possibly gonna die of COVID. We're gonna give even yeah, Biden was like Biden was like, I'm gonna pull all my ads against you because like you're sick. That's cool. And Trump goes and he's like, no, I'm stronger than this. It's nothing. It's just a flu. Don't fear it. And like meanwhile
and
he's like
okay, we'll take up the mantle.
Yeah. So it's been a shit show.
Bro, take a week. Stop infecting your person. Stop infecting your staff.
No, he's got a Supreme Court to stack.
Don't get me started on that shit.
Did you mute your mic?
Who?
Christine.
Oh.
I think she's being really quiet.
She's looking at Kat, it looks like.
Yep. And then there was the whole thing with the debate and him being an ass during the debate. And...
Didn't the moderator at one point just say, shut up?
No, Joe Biden said, shut up. Joe Biden went, will you just shut up, man?
You know, there was a very interesting tweet I saw that someone's like, that was great, but how many times has Hillary wanted to say it? And she replied, like, dude, you have no idea.
Yes. Yeah. I saw that tweet.
I saw, like, one of the polls recently. Like, apparently Biden is, like, 4 times as far ahead of Trump as Clinton was. at this point 4 years ago. I'm like, oh, so the DNC just needed to pick a conservative to run it against Trump, and they win.
Yeah, because Biden is very centrist.
Yes. That's what's the word?
Generous.
Generous.
Yeah.
That's generous to call him centrist.
I'd rather have Biden than an almost literal fucking Nazi. So.
Yeah. We shouldn't be at that point, though.
We shouldn't be, but that's where we are.
Do you want Biden or the Fuhrer?
We shouldn't be at the point where the guy who authored the 94th crime bill is against student loan forgiveness and told a black radio host, "You ain't black if you don't vote for him." We should be at the point where he's the better candidate.
All right, guys, I'll leave the political talk to you guys. I gotta peace out. I will hopefully be on next week. If not, I'll be on the week after.
Bye, Steve.
Bye.
Yeah, no, I agree. Shit's fucked, yo.
Anger!
Even Danny was angry about that. You hear that?
Even Danny's angry.
Biden is the appetizer that you taste while walking around the store and you get the product overall. I mean, 100% Biden picked Kamala Harris. Or, yeah, Kamala. Yeah.
Yeah.
Because she's going to run for president in 2024.
He picked a literal cop.
Yeah. And she's going to run for president in 2024.
Yeah.
She'll be the DNC's pick. Just watch.
There's a great there's another great tweet I saw that was like, Biden's the guy you date just after you get out of an abusive relationship and makes you realize that you're into women.
I almost spit out my drink.
You're gonna kill Mike. You're going to kill Ember Reviews, Monica. You're going to kill Ember Reviews, and Annie Tubers everywhere will weep. We're clipping that.
Oh, maybe I don't like dudes.
We're clipping that.
Maybe I'm riding a pink canoe. Who knows?
Maybe I like tacos more than sausages.
Oh, goodness.
Yes, hello. I'm here for the Yuri. I was told there'd be Yuri. What?
I am leaving because there is no
it's
Yuri.
Just undertones and edgy Hello Kitty reference.
Bye, Cat. Oh. I'm sorry I cleaned your ears and now they don't...
Was that Digibro?
No, that was Demo.
Demo.
No,
damn it.
No, you don't. No, you told me. No, streets. Undertones are not Yuri, okay? they're not. I am... You had one job. My coffee maker had one job.
Coffee.
I didn't have to do that every single day.
We have coffee.
Okay? I'm not on the receiving end of coffee undertones. They're girls. If they're not doing gay things at each other, then what are they good for?
I remember that video.
Oh my goodness.
Monica, I'll send you that so you could...
It's a watch.
He was doing like a seasonal preview guide, and one of the shows was like hinting at lesbian stuff, but wasn't going all the way with it. So,
my goodness!
Ooh, kitty.
I'm getting sleepy, man.
Also, I don't know. This may be lost, but I just need to voice this thought out there because it's been rattling around in my brain. The more I'm in, I started a new job a couple weeks ago and I've had to commute back in the office. And the more that I'm in there, the more that I'm hating the fact that how to succeed in business without really trying has aged so well. Like, there are certain parts of it that haven't aged as well, but like the whole concept. And the thing that triggered that thought is there's literally a song about the coffee maker breaking down and everyone just going insane. Like, I need my coffee. No coffee. That's where my brain went and how we got on that thought.
Also, I just like to point out how I crushed it at Topgolf.
Oh, did you? Yeah,
that last
Topgolf?
Fucking swing.
Oh god, yeah. So
that last swing.
Yeah, so we went to Topgolf. Sorry, Monica, we didn't invite you or like Steve.
Eh, it's fine.
Because well, part of it was like, well, we don't want to pick one of the other, but whatever. So we went to Topgolf, and it was like the last swing. I had like a minute left on our timer. And Ryan was ahead by like 20 points or something. And I was kind of like, I've got to go big on this one.
You motherfucker.
And I just, boom! And I like swing it all the way to like the back line. Like the farthest back you can hit it. And it was like 75 points. Woo! I was
I'll still
very
take my
happy
from the the time before.
Did you go Saturday? Because if so, I was busy as shit that day and wouldn't have been able to go anyway.
We did go Saturday.
It was Saturday.
Yeah, I was busy as shit that day, so.
Yay! Don't feel bad.
You're fine.
And Steve was getting on a plane.
I knew that was going for the back like as soon as you hit it.
Yeah, because it was like sailing. Like you could see it like getting carried by the wind or something. And I was like, come on, baby! I'm getting okay at golf, at least at the drive part of it.
I don't like that.
Yeah,
I don't like that.
I want to go more. Like, I like...
Next time me and Ryan are combining our scores just so you don't win.
Well, hold on. Ryan is good at it, okay?
Yes, I'm aware.
The dual thing, I just got lucky.
I don't think I've ever done any sort of traditional golf swinging ever, so I'd probably be shite at Topgolf.
Yeah, I mean, it's something where we went with... So Christine's parents, her mom and dad, both very avid golfers. They love golf. We went to Topgolf for Christine's birthday a couple weeks ago, and Christine's dad kind of gave us some pointers and stuff, and like... Very good pointers, because I applied them when we went with Mike and Ryan last week, and like I could tell I was getting better, and so I'm kind of like, oh, I need to do this more often because it's fun. I like it.
I literally, when I saw you take your first swing when I was down, I'm like, oh no.
Yeah, I've improved.
Oh, no. As the guy who's like sort of close to being the athlete in the group, I don't like the fact that you're getting better.
Golf isn't athletics.
You say that, and then you try golf.
Golf is rich white people with too much time.
Golf is also like the most unnatural, like there's so many things you have to concentrate on when like you hit the ball.
Goddamn Scots ruining everything.
Scots. Damn the Scottish. Originated? Yeah, Scotland.
Yeah, Scots. Yeah.
Joe Biden is the political equivalent of wanting a nice latte from Coffee Hound or Starbucks and getting Circle K coffee, but that's much better than drinking the rotting meat juice that is Trump.
Fair.
Yeah, that's fair. Yeah.
Oh, Coffee Hound.
I want coffee.
Coffee.
Things. I got this from Maggie.
Nice. I miss Maggie.
I got
Maggie
this on my 21st birthday, actually.
Nice.
They had a special and where you could get I forget what the drink is called, but they made it with Two Gingers whiskey and they would give you the glass.
Nice.
Back to the golf thing. When I ordered a hockey jersey about like a month ago.
Mm-hmm.
And when it came in, it came with a 3-pack of golf balls.
Nice.
And it's a name brand one too. Yeah. And they got their logo on it.
Nice.
Nice. Okay.
I'm not using these. These are too good.
Well, also at Topgolf, like they'd be useless.
Well, yeah, I know, but like just to use in other like when we go actual golfing.
Gotcha. I do want to try actual golf eventually.
No.
That being said, I think it's a good time to end the podcast. Does anyone
been to actual golf. It's no.
No, Mike, I'll you've been playing. No, you've been playing with your dad, who is competitive. We play together. We're like, oh shit, the ball went in the pond. Oops, let's have a mulligan.
Or the beach.
Go or to the beach. Beach. Going to the beach.
Dude, I go to the beach so much.
Does anyone have any ending thoughts or anything?
Cats are the best.
Vote.
But I can't wait for my dog.
Oh, I just got my absentee ballot in the mail on Friday.
So register to vote. Another.
Check, please check out, if you live in Illinois, please check out the new amendment that they're going for.
I have it on my kitchen table. I haven't read it.
Think about what's in it. Just don't blindly go, yeah, that sounds good. Read the whole thing and just think about it.
Do you want your phone or not?
Oh, yeah. Christine and I are paleo right now, and Ryan's asking, is Dick paleo?
Technically, yes.
Because cavemen could have Dick.
but is it kosher?
It's not kosher.
Depends if it's been blessed by a Jewish priest.
And the Jewish rabbi.
I'm sorry, yes.
Has not blessed rabbi. Your dick. So no, Kevin's dick ain't kosher. Fun fact.
Yeah. Anyways.
I feel like kosher is different than paleo, though.
It is.
Thank you so much for joining us for episode 18 of the VGR cast. We are legal now. So
we've been legal for several days.
So thank you guys so much for joining us. And we'll be back with something in a few minutes. We don't know what yet. But we will see you guys shortly. And then tomorrow, join me and Mike for Halo and Lasso,
Mike,
I guess.
Join
Mike and I for Halo and Lasso. So make sure you're following. So you know when that happens.
Guess I'm going to watch some murder shows.
See you later, guys. Bye-bye.
Godspeed, Matt King.
Stay royal.
That's bullshit.
Stay royal.
No.
Stay royal.
Get out of here. No.
Stay royal.